Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at ValderBeebeShow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/ValderBeebeShow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Good day and welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show, as I've got some great guests coming up for you. I want you to really listen to Dr. Gustavo Flores and Laura Rodriguez. They have some information that you can only find through walking the walk, and I think they've walked the walk. Dr. Gustavo, I'm going to start off with you. I read that it's estimated that over 350,000 out-of-hospital cardiac arrests occur each and every year, and 90% of them are fatal. Can you speak to that for me?
Yes. Out-of-hospital cardiac arrest happens fairly frequent, and survival depends on bystanders rendering immediate help. And lack of early bystander CPR and early use of an automated external defibrillator, such as an AED, is associated with poor survival rates. Survival depends on the willingness of others to lend a hand, or to literally. At the forefront of this is early CPR by those bystanders who witness the event and initiate this chain of survival.
Dr. Gustavo, one time there was a big push, commercials and PSAs for people to get trained in CPR. I don't see that. Maybe I'm just missing that. So to me, that tells me less people know CPR. How do we get people to be CPR trained?
We are actually trying to get the message across a broader even playing field right now. We are even recommending that states mandate that all high school students be trained before graduating. And we're also recommending hands-only CPR through our website at cpr.heart.org. And we're actually advocating that many people who have particular needs because they are facing learn how to do this basic steps. So there's a lot of things we can do, but we're trying to taking strides to increasing the awareness across the board.
I'm going to switch to Laura. Laura, can you tell us about your experience with cardiac arrest and receiving bystander CPR, which I probably assume saved your life?
Yes, it is correct. I am a survivor for pulmonary resuscitation, CPR. This happened at my daughter's school when I suddenly collapsed. I had the death syndrome, so I didn't have any symptoms, and I was feeling well enough to walk into the school, and I was at the right place at the right time, and the school nurse was able to recognize that seeing me on the floor wasn't just a fainting episode, it was a cardiac arrest. So she immediately started CPR, and my survival time now is 14 years. My daughter was 5 years old when I was taking her into the school. And now I am here with my pacemaker defibrillator, which has saved my life 9 times through all these years.
I'm so glad that your life was saved so you could tell your story and my audience can hear it. So I thank you for sharing. Dr. Gustavo, she talked about a nurse professional saving her life. To me, that was a blessing, because how many times do you have a nurse in a crowd of people? But you also talked about earlier defibrillators. How many people have defibrillators?
You'd be surprised. I'm always surprised every time I see one in any public place, but it's not uncommon to see them. So they're more prevalent as you walk across places. Sometimes because you may not be aware that they're located when you walk in, you don't realize. But now that you're trained, you're paying attention and you're realizing that AEDs are around us in many places that we visit on a daily basis.
Can ordinary citizens get trained in the use of a defibrillator, or is this reserved for healthcare professionals?
Oh, absolutely. Any person can learn how to use an AED. Think of it as an analogy would be like a fire extinguisher. You don't have to have any special training to learn how to use it. We even can coach you. 911 can provide real-time instructions on how to use it in case of an emergency. And the AED itself provides verbal cues on how to proceed. So first step is turning it on, and it's going to guide you step by step. Again, the message is very clear. This is easy, and you can do it. We want to empower you to start CPR, get that AED, and get it started, because it's going to coach you how to operate it. Getting trained is also going to help.
Where can my audience get more information on anything we've spoken about in this conversation?
You can visit the American Heart Association's website at cpr.heart.org.
Dr. Gustavo, I really thank you for coming in and being in the Valder Beebe Show studio. And Laura, I'm definitely excited that you were here to share your story. Thanks for being my guest, both of you, on the Valder Beebe Show.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.